Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Barbell, and welcome back to some more Skyrim action. In the last episode, we traveled through Darkfall Cave and then Darkfall Passage in order to end up here at the Forgotten Vale in some random isolated spot in Skyrim that nobody cares about. I guess that's why it's the Forgotten Vale. Anyway, we are here to get Ariel's bow, and we are nearing the end of the Dawnguard questline. How sad. But this area is fairly large, so it's not going to be covered in one episode. So we got a little time left here. And something I just realized. Open. God damn, open. Thank you. Look at my health and my stamina. And my magicka, I guess. This whole thing is going to be outside. Or a large majority of it is going to be outside. I just realized that. This is going to be a real pain. 120 health. And lots of Falmer. Falmer for everybody. Plenty to go around. So hopefully I don't get my ass beat. Anyway, let's go ahead and head on up. We are about to discover the fast travel marker. And, look at that! Forgotten Vale discovered. Look at this area. Oh, in case you are wondering, yes, you can fast travel from the Forgotten Vale. Once you discover this thingy right here, you can come on back whenever you want. What you know about that junk, this although... incredible.
It's like a whole other world.
It's like it was added on by DLC or something. Just kind of plopped here out of nowhere. Who knew? I need to adjust my headset real quick. Turn up the volume. Pump up the volume. Oh, that's a deer. Just got to keep the armor ready to rock. There are Vale. Oh, there's one right now. I was about to say there are Vale saber cats spooking around out here. And seeing as I have decreased health already, I do not want to get owned. Now, there are a few things you can get here in the Forgotten Vale that are not necessary. There are 5 paragons based off of the gems. There's amethyst, emerald, ruby, sapphire, and diamond. And the paragons take you to different areas of the map that you cannot... Ah, shit! Get on the rocks! Get destroyed. Get destroyed. Anyway, the paragons take you to places that are otherwise unaccessible or inaccessible on the map. That can lead to goodies. And oh, cut now what? Oh, spiders. And the plan, I say, is to only acquire one of them. I will go out of my way only to acquire one of them, and that is the Ruby Paragon. And I will explain why in just a second. Let's take care of these fools. They won't know what hit them. Get blastoed! Oh, up the rock wall! Look at that junk! I believe there's a giant frost spider up here, too. Let's regenerate a little magicka here. Alright, let's do this.
More spiders? I like the ones back home.
Where'd you come from? How do you like the ones back home better? They're all equally ugly and terrifying. Ah! Jesus, Serana, I hate it when you do that shit. Oh hell yeah, guys! Level up less than 5 minutes into the episode. That is how we roll. Whoa, he tripped. Yeah, let's go ahead and initiate this. What is my health when I'm not in the sun? I don't remember. Is it 200? Let's go ahead and magicka it up. Perks to increase. Do I have this? Yes, I already have that. How's my restoration doing? Whoa. 21 levels to go until I can get that. I'm probably gonna put this into alteration somehow. Somehow, some way. Let's see here. Oh, I think that's gonna be it. But I could get an expert level alteration spell. Damn it, fellas. Decisions. You know what? I hate to do this, but I'm going to fast travel to the college. Because I'm going to be facing a lot of Falmer here. And some are going to be rather high level. And I want the best defense I can possibly have. Especially since I'm going to be outside with low health. For all I know, all the armor in the world won't save me when my health is only at 120. But I'd like to think it'll help. So let's go ahead and pay Tolfdir a visit. What is... You guys see that guy creeping back there? What is he doing? He's following that high elf! Lady! Rape whistle! Blow it! He's following you! And it's creepy. Tolfdir, where would you be? Dude, seriously, you're freaking people out. Ankano is dead. Gone. No, he's not in the countenance. He's in the students' one. What the fuck? What the? Wait a minute. Oh. Oh, okay. I thought there was a duplicate of that guy. They were both dark elves, and they looked kind of similar. Okay, where are you at, Tolfdir? Tolfdir? No, that's Shizargo. God damn it. I hear somebody eating. Is he up here? Or was that Shizargo eating? No, it's that douchebag. God damn it. Okay, I did not intend to stop here and waste all this time. Sorry, guys. I apologize. I should have done this off camera, but I just thought of it. On Moon, the creepy stalker. There you are.
Good to see.
Silence.
Wish to master the arcane arts.
We've gone over this. I've already mastered them, damn it. I just need to buy your book, Ebony Flesh. Ooh, detect life could be handy also. I shall buy both. Shit, let's detect undead as well. Why not? Let's buy all the things. Okay, Hell yeah. Hell yeah, now let's go ahead and favorite. Get out of here. Iron flesh. Nobody likes you. Ebony flesh. That's where it's at. Equilibrium. That'll just kill me, so might as well unfavorite that. And detect dead and life. There we go. Oh, and I need to... God, this is not fun to watch. I know. I'm sorry. One last thing before I travel back. That is to get the expert perk. All right. All that tedious junk is done and over with. Now let's go back to the Forgotten Vale to get our ass beat by Falmer. Oh yeah, I was going to explain why I wanted to get the Ruby Paragon. And that is, there is a special item here in the Forgotten Vale called Ariel's Shield. Not just the bow, but... Ah, it put me way back here, damn it. The bow is the story item, but there's also Ariel's Shield. And I didn't actually get this when I played Dawnguard myself, I don't know, whenever it came out. I didn't realize it even existed until after I completed it. And Ariel's Shield, when you block a certain number of attacks, it charges the shield. And if you build up enough charges, I think it's 3 charges, it'll actually unleash a Fushroda type push when you shield bash someone. And I'm assuming once you shield bash, it uses all the charges. And I think it's 5 to 6 successful blocks to build 1 charge. So there you go. You're looking at like 17, 18 blocks to get a full... Or 3 charges and get the full Fushroda like blast. And I thought that might be pretty interesting to show you guys. Whoa, that looks like a... Looks like a dragon's head, kind of. I don't know, maybe I'm just seeing things. And the Ruby Paragon is not out of the way. It's actually inside of the Inner Sanctum, which is where we need to go later on in this quest.
By the blood.
Oh, there you go again, saying by the blood. Weirdo. Oh. And those are the other unique items you can get here in the Forgotten Vale. There's four ancient Falmer tomes. Skeleton's on that chest. He does not want to give it up. Give me the arrows. Give me the emerald. Give me that. I'll take that too. Get off of there, silly skeleton. I can't stand it either. You know I'm a vampire too, right? Oh, is it nighttime? Almost. Sweet. Yeah, there's four ancient Falmer tomes that you can get. And you take those to Urak Grow Shrub. Or Shub. I don't know however you pronounce it. And it's... And I don't remember what he gives you. I think he gives you the translated versions. And something... I don't know exactly. Yes, it's a way shrine. Hello.
Prelate Seligriath. Learning initiate.
Yes.
Ariel bless you, child. For you are a step closer to the inner sanctum and everlasting wisdom.
Hooray. Now get going! Get out of my way. And every time you fill your ewer at a new new way shrine, it opens up a new portal to that way shrine. So if I traveled back to here, no, not there. The next way shrine should have a portal open to this way shrine. I don't know. I don't think I'm making sense, but hopefully it'll make sense later. One of the problems with live commentary, once you say it, you can't take it back. But that's okay. Okay, let's go ahead and move over here. Now, I apologize ahead of time, but I do not entirely remember everything about this place, so I might get a little lost sometimes. I believe... Yeah, if you go down that waterfall over there, it takes you back to Darkfall Passage, I believe. And Serana makes a comment about it too, when you're in the water. So I do not want to go that way. Let me armor it up just in case. In fact, I'm curious to see how much armor I have now. 350. So it was 300, now I have 350. Excellent, excellent. Excellent! Open the map here. God, the map in this game is just useless sometimes. Okay, it looks like I'm going the complete opposite direction. So this must lead to something extra. Oh. Well, this does lead to another unique thing here in the Forgotten Vale, and that is the second word to the Soltaire Shout. I guess we're walking on thin ice! I'd say that was a joke, but it wasn't even remotely funny, so let's just forget I even said that. Alright, it's successfully nighttime, therefore my stats do not suck as bad. Is there anything back here? Nope. Whoa. Oh, hello, chest! Swim! Fighting against the current. Give me that. Gold. Ruby. Sweet. Let's get out of here. Get up there. Alright. Now, I don't know if this is where the word is. I know it's on the frozen lake, but maybe this is the wrong one. Oh, no, what the random fade in? Okay, that's where the word is. And you guys will see what happens when you get this word. Shit goes up. What is up with this fade in junk? Settings. First of all, is this on legendary? Yes. Display. Look at that. All the fades are at max. Random. Oh well. Whoa. Ice wraiths. Whoa, let's potion it up before I get my ass beat real quick. Just regular healing. There we go. What is going on? What is up with my spells today? God, leave me alone, jerks. I'm working on it. Wow, you guys noticing that none of my spells are working right now? Oh, no, you don't. You ain't going nowheres. Okay. Now, hopefully this works. I think it should. Let's get the word. Get the chest. Ooh. Useless. Really? What a bunch of crap. I don't know, maybe my game's glitching up right now or something. Because of all these weird fade-ins and my spells just getting all wonky. Anyway, what's supposed to happen is two dragons are supposed to pop up out of the ice here. And they have a unique design. They're like twin dragons or something. They look pretty cool. But no, game refuses to do that for me. Fine. God damn it. Whoa, who? That's my Draugr I summoned! Wow! Making him do some serious cardio. He just vaporized. Okay, one of the way shrines is over there, but I think I'm gonna try. Get this one first, since it's right there. And I guess teleport back to the way shrine of learning. Instead of having to walk all the way back. Let me up there. Okay. Also, you guys may notice that this video has been recorded in 720p rather than 1080. I've done that for a couple reasons. I'll let you know after this guy says his jibber jabber. Yep.
Then go forth, child. May the enrichment of
get going!
Strengthen your resolve as you undertake your journey to the
inner. Anyway, I did it for two reasons. One, it makes the files smaller. That means I can upload faster. The 1080p files usually took between 10 hours and 12 hours to upload. And that's why I haven't been able to upload Skyrim episodes as often as I'd like. Because they take forever to upload. And I have other things I want to do also, like Doom and upload my Dead Space series. So, yeah, let's go back to here. So that made things very inconvenient. So hopefully this will decrease the file size a little bit and allow me to upload more often. And secondly, I've been working my ass off. My ass off. It is literally grinded off from all the hard work I've been doing. I've been trying to get my video quality to something that is tolerable. And it has been driving me crazy. I spend hours. Sometimes hours, days, a couple days in a row trying to figure out what the problem is. And it was really obvious in the most recent Oblivion episode, which is part 4. Where is this telling me to go? Okay, so this is where I want to go. Didn't I come from here though? Did I completely bypass? I did. Oh, I bet some of you guys were yelling at your monitors when I went past this way shrine. I forgot this was here. I'm stupid. Anyway. The video quality has just been terrible sometimes. It's very noticeable when there was a lot of high movement. The screen would suddenly get blurry for some reason, I don't know. And it's been driving me crazy because I want to put out, you know, high quality videos for you guys. Make it something entertaining to watch, but if it's getting blurry all the damn time, who wants to watch that junk? Sure, it's recorded in 1080, but doesn't mean shit if it's getting blurry. So I've been doing my best to try and fix it, and I think I may have something figured out. Well, the answer will be right in front of you because when you guys are seeing this, this video has been uploaded, so we'll see.
Welcome in. Then behold Ariel's.
And if this possible solution I have doesn't work, then I am out of ideas. Out of ideas. And hopefully you guys will be able to tolerate.
Let's get indoors or in a cave.
Be silent. It's 10:43 at night. Serana. Oh. Anyway, enough talking about terrible video quality. Good news is I can teleport back to the Shrine of Resolution. This is going a hell of a lot faster than my first attempt at this place. Sup, brah? Nobody cares about Ariel. Oops, I didn't mean to say that. I'd totally like to have your bow, Ariel. You're so cool and super awesome. Alright. And it's snowing. Reduces visibility down to crap levels. Let's go ahead and put Detect Life on 2. Oh, and it doesn't detect Serana because she's technically dead because she's a vampire. So there you go, in case any of you were wondering, but I doubt it. What is this? That little farmer hut. No one's home, apparently. This might lead up to an optional area, but I don't remember. Healing potions, I can use those. Alright, let's go up here. I think this is an optional area, but I want to make sure. Shit. God damn it. Ow. Oh, nice shock magic. Barely even felt that. That just hit me. Great, they're all alerted up there. God damn it. Falmer Skulker, I blame you.
I knew I heard something.
The hell are you talking about? Chest. A gourd? Ah! Jesus fucking Christ! I have no doubt that little yelp was pretty loud on your guys' ears, and I'm sorry. I had no idea that phone was there. I even checked my little radar thingy to make sure nothing was here. God damn it. Do I have anything that can... Magic menu open. Do I have the anti-ass kicking shield? Yes. Activate. Let me out of here. What the hell? I didn't know Serana had shock magic. What the fuck? Guys! This helps run out. I'm gonna quick save this junk, guys! I don't know where these farmers are coming from. They're sneaking around. And the last thing I want is to die now. It hasn't auto-saved in God knows how long. Now, where did that Falmer Skulker go? He was here. I was zapping him. Oh, I'm an idiot. That was the... God, Serana resurrected that Skulker. Okay. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, the bridge is up there. Oh boy, this episode is getting wonky. And I can't see anything because of the snowstorm. Oh, they're reactivated. I made them angry again. I remember using Fusro Da several times in this area. Oh! Serana, you might want to get that checked out. That looks painful. This is just prime real estate for launching things off. It is so gratifying. Okay, what the random? Oh, here we go.
Who's there?
Who do you think? Whoa. Now, well, this sucks. Oh, he's up there. Whole lot of nothing. Moving on. Guys, did you stop that? Who's here? Oh, God. Oh, look at that. There's frost trolls here, by the way. Slightly different from regular trolls. I think they're more powerful. And the frost trolls have the paragons on them. But I don't feel like fighting that guy right now. Because I don't have any use for the paragon he would give. Well, I don't know. We're here, and he's here. Let's go ahead and do that. Why not? Or at least let's try. Let's see what happens. Conjuration level up! Leveled up! Wow, look at how little damage I do. Jogger's holding his own. Oh, he's almost dead. I'm out. I'll get up here. Come on. Damn it. Come on! Yeah. Can't see him. Where'd he go? Shut yourself, you fat jerk. See him on the marker. Or on the minimap thingy. My jogger can sniff him out. Oh, he's in the tree there. Wow. I wish Serana was here. Drain that giant magicka! Drain him up! Oh shit. Alright. I know this fight kinda sucks. Oh, god damn it. Oh, cool. Come on, he's almost dead, damn it. Oh shit! Draugr doing flips and junk, going out with style. Oh, we got this, got this. Yeah! Oh, I don't think he's dead yet. Oh, yeah, he is. Don't slide off the cliffside or I will pimp smack your corpse. Thank you. There it is. Emerald Paragon. Nice. Didn't really want it, but there it is. The only reason why I got it is because you use the paragons all at the same exact spot. So, might as well. Might as well. This looks like a good place to wait and let Serana hurry up. Come on, Serana, seriously? I hear her. Thought I did. Oh, wait. Do I see lightning? Yep, she's over there doing some stupid stuff. Oh, shoot. Wound marker. Nope, need some draugr action. Back it up. Give me your magicka. I got that staff of ultimate power. Can't do nothing against that. Your gold. Oh! Oh, I thought he was gonna go off the bridge. Oh, another one? Where you at? Where you is? Where you is at? Oh, there he is. Skulker, huh? I'm gonna quick save just in case he one-shots me with an arrow. Ah, no way that's gonna kill him. Holy shit! Oh, is that an arrow in my knee? No, it's more in my guts. Or possibly even a more painful area. Let's not talk about that. See, Draugr's like, fuck that shit. I don't want to hear about that. I am out of here. Venison. Who cares? Gone. Alright.
Who's there?
Oh, there he is on the bridge. I didn't even realize Serana caught up. Boom. Boom. Kind of funny when you go into death cam mode and you've launched spells like this rather than the regular two-handed, it'll only launch one of them until the death cam is over and then it launches the other one. Kind of weird. Is there a book down here, a Falmer book? Yep, give me that. I'm not going after these, but it was there, so might as well pick it up. Okay. I think I go into that glacial crevice there. Or do I go this way? I do go this way. And that's the glacial crevice. Who wants some? No. Ooh, staff of fireball. Ugh, do not want none of that junk. Max level vampire right now. 120 health only. And super weakness to fire. Screw that noise. Ugh, thankfully he's just shooting the wall. My spells are just going right through him, because why not? Well, if he's just gonna sit there. Ugh! Ray. Ah, it's daytime! Wow, 5 o'clock counts as daytime? Didn't know that. Did not know that. Here's the glacial crevice. Alright, I think this is a good place to stop. I think we're about halfway through the Forgotten Vale area. Like I said earlier, this is going a lot faster than the first time I did this. So, that's good. Doesn't feel nearly as tedious. Anyway, going to go ahead and end the episode here. I really hope you guys enjoyed it, and I'll see you on the next one for some more Skyrim action. Take care, everybody. Bye.